I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling. Shouldn't be trusting me, I could be making it all up, you know.
Time it is that you are tuning in. This is Unapologetically Me featuring me. No special guest, just me. Today we are talking about the Kiely Rodni case, and something crazy just happened. I have been doing nothing but researching this case. I have been invested in it this whole entire week. However, this week, as in today, is back to school week for my kids. So I'm trying to like get all this information out to you guys in a timely manner while also waiting to kind of be able to debunk some rumors and just get the right information, because I am very, very big on only talking about facts. I do make my opinions on these facts. We all know that, and not everyone agrees with my opinion, but I mean, we all have opinions, right? But I just really, really, really need to get this out now. So, like I said, speaking of special guests, I don't have one for you. I wish I did, but I don't. But I'm not sure how many of you are believing in, you know, psychics or tarot readers, but I am not huge. I don't just trust anyone, but there is one woman that has done amazing things. She has helped so many people, and she truly does have a gift. Now, if you're not one to believe in that, I'm not trying to push it on you, but something happened a little bit ago that has made me sit down and finally make this video that I have literally been scripting for days. She hasn't really looked into this yet, but she did have, you know, kind of a vision. She described this person, and I just knew instantly that it is the same person that for some reason last night had me just going screenshot crazy, just taking pictures of him in connection to this case. And I don't know what it is. I haven't heard back from her. I sent her the photos. She was describing someone, and I brought up this person's name, and instantly she was like, yes, that is the name that I got.
And there was a couple things I forgot to say. One was that when they first showed me this guy she was talking to, my brother Steve came in. Now, he's deceased too, but I knew there was something in common. That's why I wasn't sure if he had strawberry blonde hair like my brother. But in the comments, somebody just wrote, did the name Steve come in at all? And I'm just like, oh my God, I didn't say that. I didn't tell anybody that. But the answer is yes. Yes. So if somebody else is getting that, it's something to look into. It's something to remember. And then I, even the other night when that came in, I looked up on a map, and there's a, there's some kind of, you know, public works type place on the way between that lake and her house that says, I think the name of it is Steve or something like that. But I doubt that's the place. It's just, when you get a name, you want to look up any clue that could be related. It could be about the person. It could be about the location. But the name Steve did come through. And apparently, one of the listeners named Unapologetically Me, she just said, did the name Steve come through? And I'm just like, oh my God. That was one of the things where I said, I'm going to make a second video. So, yes. I hope I hope all that group of people knows who that we're talking about. All right, bye.
So I don't know where this is going. She did say this doesn't mean that this person did anything or had anything to do with her disappearance. So, you know, don't go there yet anyway. But just that he's important. Like, he was there. He was there possibly at the party, and he had some words with Kiely, possibly. So waiting to see what happens with that. So while I am waiting to see what happens with that, I'm going to tell you guys the way I understand things to be, okay? Because that's all I can do here, right? I'm fact-taking from, you know, what we know so far from pressers and from, you know, things that have been confirmed. But I will be throwing in some just kind of opinions along the way. Because honestly, when you don't have any information really at all, you are left to speculate. Everyone has a theory. Even cops and FBI have a theory. Let's just get into it. All right. In case you guys do not know who I am talking about 16-year-old Kiely Rodni from Truckee, California. And Truckee, California is a small little mountain town just north of Lake Tahoe. It sits on the border of California and Nevada. It's about 30 minutes from Reno. Now, I want to keep this video as factual as possible. There's always rumors and speculation circling any of these cases, right? And I have definitely explored a few theories myself, not gonna lie. And I can only speculate along with everyone else when it comes to certain things because we just don't know. We really don't know anything. And it's been 10 days now. Thanks to social media, it's very easy to get false information mixed up with facts. I just wanna go over what we know so far that is confirmed. Friday, August 5th, 2022, 6:08 p.m., Kiely Rodni is caught on surveillance video at a local business in Truckee, California. 9:45 p.m., Kiely arrives at the Prosser family campground where there is a party being held. She arrives with her best friend, Magdalene, or Mags. They are there to meet up with Mags's boyfriend, Ross. Mags told media that she left only 10 minutes into arriving after she had been immediately confronted by a group of older guys to do some illegal, well, bong rips. Let YouTube get mad at me. They won't monetize me. I don't care anymore. Away from her boyfriend. So Mags was a little concerned right off the bat.
Within the only 10 minutes that I was there, I literally had a group of five guys try to come get me to take as many like bong rips as I could like forcefully without my boyfriend present.
There was a lot of guys that did approach us. Definitely, I was getting a gut feeling during that party that something just didn't feel right with the amount of people that were there and how old some of these people were. From the amount of people who did show up, it was scary.
It seems like she got there, she right away thought, you know what, I am not about this and I'm leaving. So she left with her boyfriend. So Kiely is now there without the person she went there with. This party was supposed to be a senior farewell party for high schoolers. Kiely, being only 16, she had graduated early with high honors, yet she was probably one of the younger kids who ended up attending that party. And keep in mind, as we walk through what we know, most of what we have learned, we are learning from an 18-year-old girl by the name of Samantha Smith, or Sammy. We will get more into her later. Sammy said from the very first interview that the party had gotten way bigger than anyone had imagined it would. She said that by 10 to 10:30 p.m., there were upwards of 250 to 300 people. Now, this number has only grown with time. It was 100, then it was 200, then it was 250, and now it's like 300. So we'll just say between 250 and 300 people. And the people came from cities that weren't exactly very close to the Prosser family campground. There were people from Reno, not too far away, Sacramento, San Francisco. I mean, we're talking an hour and a half away. Now, a few people also said that there were a lot of older guys there. This came from more than one person. Guys, even in their late 20s, 30s, and some people even reported seeing guys in their 40s there. I don't know how accurate that is. We did hear a couple reports of a creepy 40-year-old looking guy that was kind of a loner there that was like creepily looking at people. So at 11 p.m., Sammy mentioned that she and Kiely had gone back to Kiely's car to charge their phones. According to Sammy, while in Kiely's 2013 silver Honda CRV, Kiely texted her mom, Lindsay, to ask if she could extend her curfew to 12:30. Lindsay, who had just returned home from Reno, okayed the extension, which was usually 11 o'clock. She extended it to 12:30, asking that Kiely wake her up when she arrived home, which was something that they typically did if Kiely was going to be home late.
We got home around 11, and she sent me a text at 11:30 telling me that she was going to be leaving at about 12:15 and coming home. And that was, I asked her to wake me up when she got in. That was always kind of, you know, like what we did. And she said, okay, Mom, I love you. And that was the last because nobody has said that they saw her leave. They can't say for sure what's happened.
Sammy also said that during this time while they were in the car, she had asked Kiely for a ride home with her because her ride, I guess, was going to be leaving now and she wanted to stay longer. At 11:30 p.m., Kiely texted her mom saying that she would be leaving in 45 minutes to drive home. Kylie's home was about 12 miles from the party. Sammy said that they went back to the party and they split up. And according to Sammy, they were together as a pair all night long, yet they seemingly split up quite a bit. So I don't know. And this is where a lot of the inconsistencies come in. It's just kind of a hot mess. I really don't know how the police are piecing this together because it's very hard to follow. It seems that every time Sammy opens up her mouth, things get more and more questionable. So she said that they would go back to Kylie's car throughout the night while they were together to refill their drinks and that they drank from the same cup. And they went to pop a squat together in the woods. I don't know why she went into so much detail, but a lot of it was because she was saying that this is not a black tank top that is shown in the picture. It's actually a bodysuit. And she remembers this because when they went to the woods to pop a squat, it was kind of a pain in the ass, you know, with the bodysuit. Moving on to Saturday, August 6th, 2022, 12:25 a.m., Sammy said that upon meeting up with Kiely, that she noticed that Kiely was no longer in the right state of mind to be driving. So she tells Kiely that she found another ride home. And I guess they hug goodbye, say I love you to each other, and that's that. 12:33 a.m., the police have confirmed, Placer County Sheriff's Department confirmed that at 12:33 a.m., Kiely's phone is off. It is no longer having service, there's no more ping. And this has been confirmed. So that we do know. However, Sammy claims that she received a call from Kiely asking her if she still needed a ride home at 12:36 a.m. So in 3 minutes after the phone is disconnected, she gets a phone call. And I'd be interested to see, does her phone actually show 12:36 timestamp on it? And, you know, just because we don't know does not mean the police don't know. So I just want to reiterate that for anyone who, you know, doesn't really necessarily understand how some of this works, but they're not going to tell us anything that really, I mean, they're going to give us just enough to, you know, kind of keep us knowing that they're working, but they know way more than we know. And they have this tip line and they have all sorts of things. We'll get into that. So, so Sammy says, when Kiely calls her and says, do you still need a ride? Sammy says, no, I told you, like, I'm good. I left already. Like, don't you remember? We had this conversation. And Sammy said that she could still hear during that phone call that Kiely was at the party, or at least it seemed, because she said she could still hear like a party in the background. 1 a.m., someone also told police that they saw Kiely wandering or leaving the party. And this is just weird to me because she calls her mom to extend her curfew. If she's supposed to be home at 11, she's calling her mom at 11:30. So she's already late and asking to extend her curfew to 12:30, which is only an hour more, but her home is 12 miles from where she's at this campground. And so it would be about 35, 40 minute drive home, roughly, maybe 45 minutes, you know, and I just find it very odd that in that short of time span, Kiely would become so intoxicated that her friend wouldn't want to ride home with her. And I also find it even more odd that instead of her friend being like, you're not driving either, you're going to come with me, I found us a ride, rather than, oh, I found a ride, you're too effed up, like, I'm good, I found a ride, get home safe. I just find that so odd. 8 a.m., let's keep with the timeline here, you know me. Lindsay wakes up and sees that Kiely never came home. She calls Kylie's friends, who also have not heard from her either. And supposedly at 9 a.m., Kiely was supposed to meet up with her friends at Starbucks for a camping trip that they had already planned. And she never showed for that. So that definitely was a cause for concern. And Lindsay then calls 911 to report Kiely missing. Now that we have as much of a timeline as I can give you, let's go over some of the other details that we know. Kiely and her vehicle are both missing, and some partygoers spent the night there, and they said that they did not see Kiely or her car there when they woke up in the morning. As time goes on, we have more bits and pieces coming out. There is a chat center that Sammy has put together that is supposed to be for kids to go and talk and kind of say what's going on without the fear that they're going to be arrested for any underage partaking in things.
So with the team between Talk, what's going on in Tahoe City today? I wanted to reiterate this to all of the adults, all of the parents. Please do not come to this. You can drop off your kids, but drive away. Drive away as far as you can so that they cannot see you, you cannot see them, you can hear anything. I am in contact with the deputies, I'm in contact with the detectives, I'm in contact with the FBI, everybody. I am the person these kids need to be going to, and I've had a lot of people come to share the week. Anybody that knew about the party, learned about the party after, and knows anything at all, if you knew somebody who went, you knew somebody who was planning on going, you knew any drugs or alcohol that was there, you knew somebody who brought to somebody, anything at all, even if you did not know, you do not know Kiely, you never met Kiely, you have no idea what's even going on, you knew about Prosser, please come to me. Like, this is what I look like. I don't know. I'll be right here.
And it's just a little bit sus. Anyway, as I said earlier, Kiely drives a 2013 silver Honda CRV. And the license plate number is 8YUR127. Sammy said that there's also a sticker of a bull on the rear window under the windshield wiper. She described it actually as a cow with horns. I looked this up, and this is actually the sticker that is on the back of Kiely's on the back of Kiely's window underneath the wiper blade is a ram. This is a ram. This is not a bull. This is not a cow with horns. This is a ram. And I just found it so weird when I heard this interview, because I'm thinking, like, you gotta know that my phone just fell. You gotta know that this is a ram, right? Like, are you purposely trying to say the sticker is wrong, or do you really not know what's on the back of this girl's car? Because maybe you guys are not as good of friends as you would like everybody to think. It's just questionable. This is a photo of Kiely that was taken earlier in the evening on Friday, August 5th, before the party. This was on that surveillance video that they had of her at an establishment. They didn't say where. It depicts what she was wearing at the night that she disappeared. Kinda. Again, according to Sammy, she was wearing this black bodysuit and the black studded belt, but not the pants, because Kiely was wearing green Dickies pants at the party. But these look to be green Dickies pants to me. And then she also said that she was wearing black Vans to the party. Something else that was mentioned at a press conference was a hoodie. Police believe Kiely to be wearing or be in possession of when she disappeared, though Sammy did not mention this hoodie at all. This is a black Lana Del Rey hoodie that had the lyrics or phrase, "You don't want to be forgotten, you want to disappear," which is pretty cryptic given the circumstances. Although her mom did speak out, Lindsay spoke out and said, you know what, don't pay attention to those lyrics. Like, that's the last thing we need right now is people reading too much into these lyrics. And I think that's because, you know, reading into those lyrics, it kind of almost implies someone who wants to run away or, you know, just kind of get away from everyone, disappear for a while. And I know she does not want anyone to think that her daughter would run away, because she is adamant that that would never happen. But this is also, I don't have this in my script because I wrote my script up a couple days ago and I've just been adding to it. Now there's another hoodie. Interesting. The tale of two hoodies, if you will. There's this black Lana Del Rey hoodie that I just talked to you about. And there's also a white hoodie that is a Tyler, the Creator merch line hoodie. Now this is supposedly the last thing she was seen in. Someone supplied a video that shows Kiely wearing this white hoodie. So this is actually what she was last seen in. Now, Sammy, again, doesn't mention anything about any hoodie, a black one or a white one. It makes me want to ask, did you even see her at the party at all? Were you ever really with her? I mean, you're peeing together in the woods. You're, you know, drinking out of the same cup, which she made sure to say. She made sure to say she was the last one to have seen Kiely at this party. Yet she had no idea about either one of these hoodies or that she was wearing green Dickies. Just, she lost all credibility to me. I started hearing her talk in different interviews. It's like, and I just don't see a sense of urgency with her. I saw Mags, she was just torn up crying. And I'm not saying people only act a certain way when things like this happen. Obviously, everyone has their own way of dealing with things, but Sammy seems very stoic when she's questioned, and she's very take charge, and she's just got this, her whole, this narrative she wants everyone to follow, and I just don't know that I trust this girl. I'm not saying that she did anything. I just don't think I trust her. I kind of wonder if she ever really was with Kiely very much that night at all. Kiely is 5'7", 118 pounds. She has blonde hair and hazel eyes. There's also been a presser about these gold necklaces that she wears, I guess, all the time. And over the last month before she went missing, according to her family, she never took them off. So they put out a special press release outlining these necklaces and to kind of be on the lookout if anyone, they see anyone with these necklaces. That's another interesting thing to me. Now, Sammy said in one of her interviews that Kiely did not have a boyfriend and she was rocking the single life. And, you know, Sammy, another thing about her, she talks about Kiely in the past tense. I don't think I've ever heard her talk about Kiely in present tense. She was rocking the single life. She has an ex-boyfriend by the name of Jagger Westfall, who lives in Napa. He's a photographer. And Sammy said that this ex-boyfriend came the next day when he heard that Kiely was missing. And he's currently staying with Kylie's family at their home. Now, Jagger Westfall had another friend of Kylie's with him by the name of Kate Kuno. And they decided to take Fox News to Reno, where Jagger has said that he thought Kiely might be, but he also said that he is certain that Kiely is alive and well, and that he and two or three or others will be the ones to bring her home.
Afternoon together on Friday, just hours before she disappeared.
The day of the party, I hung out with her. We made creme brulee. Everything was normal. I don't think she ran away or anything. I mean, I would have noticed if something was slightly off.
While law enforcement, including the FBI, continue their search in and around the Prosser campground and reservoir, Jagger, Kate, and another friend went to Reno to search for themselves for Kiely. Only Fox 40 News was invited to go along. Kate says they were in Reno the day before the party, and Reno is a place Jagger and Kiely could go for some alone time. We followed them to a location in the hills where Jagger and Kiely spent some time in the past.
I definitely feel like that in this current situation that she's safe. I don't know where she is. We don't have anything to go off of at this point, but I fully believe that she's alive and well, and I fully believe that the two of us, three of us, or other people are going to bring her home safe.
I praise his optimism, and hopefully that's all that it is, but I also question it because I question a lot about Jagger. I question a lot about Sammy. I question a lot about these teens, and it could very well be just that they are young and they are scared and they were really messed up that night. I don't know about Jagger, but Sammy admitted that she was inebriated. I just question a lot. Here's partly why. Sammy has taken on the lead role of organizer for the searches and the tips. And she has said that she is a very good friend of Kiely's, that she loves Kiely, and they were together all night, drinking from the same cup, peeing together. But here, an interesting fact about Sammy is that there's absolutely zero friendship record between her and Kiely. Like, social media-wise, there's nothing. They're not following each other. There's no tagged photos together. There's no locations tagged together. Nothing. No proof that they were good friends at all. You know who Sammy did have a connection with on social media is Jagger. People pointed this out, and it could be that they have this connection now. Maybe they weren't following each other before, but they're following each other now because they're kind of working together for the same cause, which is to find Kylie. Sammy had connections with a lot of people, but she did not have any with Kylie. Sammy has said that she believes that many of the teens that attended this party are not talking because they're afraid to come forward because of some of the underground, activities that might have been going on there and underage drinking. Because of this, she put together, like I said, her own peer group / meeting place / chat talk group cult, I don't know, where she can get any and all information that the teens may be too afraid to go to the police with and kind of like weed through it. That's a little sus to me because they're basically getting all these kids in a spot where, for all we know, she's telling them don't talk, but that's speculation. Okay, but Sammy and Jagger have even gone as far as to post all over social media to contact them first as opposed to law enforcement, and that everything is supposed to be filtered through them first, which law enforcement came out and actually said this is not true. Obviously that's what these tip lines are for. This is what the website is for, and these phone numbers and all of this is for, is that's where you send your tips. We're not telling you, we've never once said go to Jagger Westfall or Sammy Smith with all of your concerns and all your tips and photos and videos. They're saying that, but law enforcement came out and said no, this is false, we have never told them, we want them filtering anything. Nevertheless, these two are really pushing themselves out there. Jagger pulled back, he got some backlash, he even removed the missing flyer that he posted about Kylie. I don't know why he would do that. I don't think he expected the backlash that he was getting, but unfortunately social media monsters can just be a nightmare, to say the least. And the poor mother too, I'm sure, is getting it, because anytime a kid goes missing, it's got to be the parents' fault somehow, and that's just not true. But unfortunately there are people out there who just want to blame. And I think he just freaked out. Sammy's still going ham, okay? So, and what's wrong with that, you may be asking. I mean, she's definitely making sure that no one forgets about this case. But Sammy isn't that much of a friend to Kylie, in my opinion. And Jagger is Kylie's ex-boyfriend. And I'm sure he's the ex for a reason. My opinion on why I don't believe Sammy and Kylie were that close is not just because there's no digital footprint of a friendship between them. I just don't believe that anyone who is good friends with someone would behave at all in the manner that Sammy behaved that night. By her own admission, in many different interviews, her story, while it has fluctuated a bit, one thing has remained the same. She asked Kylie for a ride home so that she could stay later. Upon realizing that Kylie was too intoxicated to drive her home, she just simply went and found herself another ride, basically saying, good luck and good day, I'm out. No good friend would allow another good friend who was too intoxicated to drive home, drive home. No good friend would leave another good friend who's a female too intoxicated to drive home at a party with 250 to 300 people, many of them random older guys who are pushing illegal substances on females, and just leave her like that alone. Max is gone. Sammy seemed to be the only other one that has come forward to say that she was even with Kylie, and now she's gone too. Who does that? Sammy stated in every single interview that she gave that Kylie was not in the right state of mind to drive. She also stated in every single interview that she gave that the party was intimidating and larger than expected by hundreds. And it also included a lot of older guys. Sammy did not state in any interview so far that she offered Kylie a ride home with whom she was getting a ride home with. She's not stated in any interview so far that Kylie denied wanting a ride home or taking a ride home. She never once has said, and I asked Kylie, you know, girl, you need to just come home with me. And Kylie was like, nope, I'm good. I'm staying the night here, whatever. Sammy had no idea what Kylie's plans were, nor did she ever ask her. And she has never said otherwise. In my opinion, that is not something a good friend would do. And you don't even have to be besties. Like, that's your wingman, basically. You have designated each other to stick together, and you just left her. And I just think that is not something a good friend would do. Sammy's timeline, again, is very concerning. It's because according to her, Kylie went from fine to drive her home to annihilated in 45 minutes. And of course, that can happen. I just find it very hard to believe, like, this is about to be your ride home. Why are you even, like, allowing her to continue, you know, to drink if that's what she's doing, or to do anything else if this was the plan? Kylie's mom said that Kylie would never drive intoxicated. She wouldn't. In fact, there was a time when her younger sister or her sister had an issue to where she needed to get to the hospital, and they called Kylie to come give her a ride or something. And Kylie's like, I'm so sorry, I can't. Like, I've been drinking. So I just feel like I don't think Kylie would have purposely gotten herself messed up knowing she was going to drive home. But I don't know. I mean, I don't know Kylie. I don't know Sammy. I don't know Jagger. I don't know any of these people. But it all just does not sit right with me. And I just feel that things are being hidden, whether they're small things that are being hidden, you know, that maybe aren't even connected to her disappearance at all, but yet it's bringing suspicion on them. So I don't know. But Sammy said that Kylie called her at 12:36, right? 3 minutes after Kylie's phone turned off. She also stated that during that call, she was already in a car on her way home and that Kylie was still at the party. Sammy made it a special point to say that when she received that call from Kylie, that she was in the passenger seat. And does that mean anything? Maybe not, but I did find it odd because who, when they're explaining, you know, yeah, I got a phone call and I was in the passenger seat, who says that? You know, you might be like, I got a phone call and I was driving, you know, so that I can't talk, I'm driving, right? But who says, and I was in the passenger seat, and she said it very just like pointedly, like, make sure you remember I said passenger seat. Sammy took control of the narrative immediately, and she's been controlling it ever since. Sammy told us that she believes that Kylie was abducted and could be halfway across the country by now, and that was on day two. Jagger came in suddenly, you know, and he brought this news crew to Reno and very confidently told us all that he knows that Kylie is alive and well and that he will be the one to bring her home. Mags has spoken a little bit, and she said that the older guys at the party basically freaked her out. I'm only speculating here, but it sounds to me like these guys were there for a reason. I mean, they wanted to get the younger girls messed up in order to take advantage of them. I mean, I'm not going to beat around the bush here. I've been to many parties in the past myself. We can't be naive when it comes to things like that. There's been talk about a lot of substances, illegal substances, being free to the females. I'm sorry, illegal substances are never free. No one's going to just give you illegal substances for free. There's always something that goes along with it. And if it's not money, it's time, it's something, it's something. Sammy agreed with Mags on the fact that there were a lot of older guys there and a lot of strangers there. Yet, she didn't bring the strangers part up until Mags did. She talked about how the party was, it got very big very quickly, and it was intimidating, but she didn't bring up that there was a lot of older, strange guys there until Mags did. It was almost like she, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. It was all, like, was she just so out of her mind she didn't know what the hell was going on the whole night? I mean, then just say that. Then just say you have no clue what the hell went on, because you got people sitting here hanging onto your every word. You know, and now it's like, I just can't trust this girl. That leads me to say, I want to give all these kids the benefit of the doubt. They're still kids, and they were under the influence, and it was dark, and it seemed that there was 250 plus people there, and there was probably a lot going on. And like I said, I'm no stranger to parties. Certainly, as I got older, the intensity of what was available at these parties increased as far as party favors are concerned, if you get what I'm saying. There was no difference here. This party ended up with many different party favors, and the people who supposedly brought them were these older guys. They were all for giving them to girls in exchange for company, some people have said. Kiely's mom, Lindsay, is an absolute mess. She clearly blames herself for falling asleep and not noticing Kiely was missing any sooner than 8 a.m. She says to Kiely in a plea, "I'm so sorry." She also calls herself a bad mom. I really feel for her. She's getting a lot of backlash on social media, and I can only hope she's not looking at it. The nerve of some people is just absurd. Like, get off your high horse and sit the F down. Like, put yourself in someone else's shoes. Why don't you get up and start looking for her then? Couch crusader. From what I can understand about Kiely, Lindsay had no reason not to trust her or her friends. I have an 18-year-old, almost 19-year-old, and other ages as well, and she's going off to college. You can't lock them in a cage. You can teach them how to be safe. You can teach them right from wrong. You can try to educate them the best as you can about dangers and, you know, things to look out for. And you can do check-ins and phone calls and text messages and curfews. But at the end of the day, they are teenagers. They may lie to you. They may sneak around. Their friends may cover for them. This poor mother, in my opinion, did everything right aside from tell her no. You can't go to this party. You're too young. No. But she had no reason to feel that way. This was supposed to, from what I understand, they would have these little get-togethers at this campground very often. It wasn't like this was once in a lifetime kind of thing. This was something that was regular, and this was supposed to be kind of the same as it always had been. Maybe bigger as in like the whole school instead of just, you know, groups of kids, but it's certainly not people from San Francisco. I think that if that was known, I think her mother probably would have said no. Don't you think she already knows all of this? Even the kids who threw the party had no clue how big it was going to get. I'm not gonna rant, but dang. I just feel for this mother. I feel for the family. I feel for all of them. And I really, really do hope that Kiely is found and that Jagger's right, that she is alive and well. Maybe she needed to clear her head. Although, I'm very nervous that that is not what it is. But, you know, you gotta hold on to hope. It is a possibility that she's struggling with something and she had to just take a break from life. I don't know. But again, I'm kind of leaning more towards something else. There were rumors, 911 calls to, and like a police scanner where they were talking about finding the vehicle. That's false. The black tank top that was found, that's false. She wasn't even wearing a black tank top. It was a black bodysuit. There was a body found. Yes, there was. It was a dog. Okay. She is still missing and her vehicle is still missing. You want to go over some issues? We can go over issues that I have. One, Kiely wasn't planning on even going to this party. Mags wanted to go to see her boyfriend, Ross. Kiely takes Mags to the party. Mags ends up leaving after only 10 minutes. Did Kiely stay for Sammy? Did Sammy say, "No, girl, don't leave. Like, let's hang out. I'll hang out," you know? Sammy admits she was inebriated. She also admits they were a little pair all night, yet they split up to mingle with different groups throughout the night. At 11, Sammy and Kiely and a couple others went to Kiely's car to charge their phones. Who are these other people? They were in the car for 30 to 45 minutes. What else did they do in that 30 to 45 minute window? Were they all there that whole time, or was it just Kiely and Sammy that were in the car? Sammy asked for a ride home during this time in order to stay longer, but 3 minutes after going back into the party, Sammy found another ride because she said Kiely was too intoxicated. So Kiely, according to Sammy, went from fine to drive to completely blitzed in a matter of minutes. So what happened at that car? I feel that's where we need to look between, you know, 11 and like 12:15. Something happened in that time frame, if something happened at all. Sammy was with Kiely all night up until that last car charging. So I have a couple theories. I have a few theories, but I think I want to hold off on them right now, because I think one thing I definitely think that if something were to have happened, something happened in that time and when they were in the car. And I don't know, you guys, is driving me absolutely insane. I would really like to hear what Reverend Donna Serafina has to say after getting those pictures. I'm not talking about it yet because I don't want to like put anyone on blast. But I mean, you guys are smart. I mean, you can go over to Donna Serafina's page, so, or channel, see what we were talking about there. But, anyway, I will talk to you guys later. Hopefully we hear some good news soon, or hopefully we can at least figure out whether or not we can trust these kids, because honestly, this has got to be terribly tragic, for Jagger. I mean, this is his ex-girlfriend. You know, if he didn't have anything to do with it, he's, I mean, got to be completely tore up, because not only is she gone and missing, but he's, some people believe he's responsible. And I haven't wiped him off my slate either. I mean, to me, they're all suspects at this point. And I think to police, they are too. So I guess we'll just have to wait it out, wait and see. Anyway, I will shut up and stop rambling, and I will talk to you guys later. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, whatever, comment, and I will be back with another video as soon as I can. Talk to you guys later.